Blackmagic Design is one of the sponsors of my trip here to BVE 2014 in London, and I wanted to give you a chance to understand a little bit more of the strategy that Blackmagic Design is going through as they've expanded their product line. I'm talking with Stuart Ashton, who is the director for EMEA, which is Europe, Middle East, and Asia. And Stuart is, well, let's just say he knows a lot about what Blackmagic is doing. Stuart, welcome. Glad to have you with us.
Hi, thank you for having me again.
Is there anything new with the show?
Nothing new, but what this is an opportunity is for everybody who in the UK has not seen some of these products from IBC and NAB, really to get that touch and feel experience, being able to get close to the products, being able to see how they work, and ask all those Blackmagic guys really what these products actually do.
You have to understand that this is about just about 2 minutes before the show closes. The booth is packed. Earlier today, there were so many people standing in a booth, we couldn't even record the interview without being about five booths away. So to say people are getting their hands on is a relative, they're crowded around the booth just to be able to see some of the products that are here. What's been some of the most popular stuff?
Well, I think for us, we look at the color correction, we look at ATEM, we look at the cameras. Those are three areas that are showing a lot of interest to our customer base and for all of these users out here. The UK is a very creative space with a lot of very interesting projects going on at the moment. And I think that when people are starting to look at our Ultra HD workflows, it's really starting to capture their imagination about where 4K can fit within their day-to-day.
You finally started shipping the cameras. The most recent is the 4K camera. Why the 4K camera? What does it do? What makes it special?
Well, I think that the first thing with this camera is that anybody who's experienced working with the 2.5K Blackmagic Cinema camera, they'll experience these fantastic, wonderful looking images. And also a camera that is so diverse, but yet easily utilized with many different third party accessories and interchangeable lenses. It really gives you the complete package. The 4K camera is the same form factor, it's the same weight. But the main differences are it's got a super 35mm sensor, it's also got a global shutter, and it's got 12 stops of dynamic range with 6GB SDI output. So what you're getting here for less than £2,000 or less than $3,000 is a hell of a camera with a lot of features and a great opportunity to work with all those beautiful lenses that you already own.
And what codec does it use for recording?
So you can actually record in ProRes, in a ProRes HD or a ProRes 4K, but also as well as going to be a release for a visually lossless Cinema DNG RAW as well, which so anybody who wants to work in a RAW file type can actually utilize that codec as well.
I was just reflecting over the last 5-10 years that Blackmagic has been around. It started with doing capture cards, and then all of a sudden it seems to explode in a lot of different areas. What's the strategy driving behind the products that you're coming up with? Why so many and why so wildly different?
I think this has been a fantastic roller coaster of a ride. I mean, I look at the experience that we've had within Blackmagic over the last few years and some of the successes that we've had, and it's been a great opportunity for us to really, really help out in areas of the industry where there was a demand. I think that when you start with capture cards, you really focus in on the area that you're most proficient at, which was the post-production area. And then with acquisitions like DaVinci Resolve, and obviously acquisitions with the ATEM production switches, and then obviously more recently with Syntel, what it does is it starts to open up your imagination into all of these new areas that you can take that existing technology and just emphasize it or make it slightly better, but also as well drop on this attitude that we've got as well of the entry of barrier, really, which is making sure that it's most affordable for everybody. I think that one of the greatest challenges that you have in any business when you're manufacturing products is that you set the price too high, and that means that nobody ever really gets the opportunity to work with it. For us, we very much hold in value the quality, the accessibility, and obviously that cost. And I think that that's what's worked very well for us, really.
But one of the problems that you've got when you start to diversify wildly is you're outside your comfort zone, and there's a chance of stuff falling through the cracks. And I look at the shipping delays with the cameras as a classic example. It was something new for the company, and some of the cameras took a whole lot longer to design and release than were expected. Do you run the risk of doing too much in too many different areas and too many plates bouncing at the same time?
Do you know, I don't think it's so much about trying to balance too many plates. I think it's about making sure that the quality level of what you produce is always at the highest possible level. For us as a manufacturer, what we don't want to do is deliver a product out into the market with substandard quality. you know, you can be shouted at 1,000 times because something's a month or two delayed, and people can be knocking on your door saying, when are you going to deliver it? But we owe our customers, and we owe ourselves the right to ensure that we deliver what we said we were going to deliver, and we commit to delivering that quality. And for us, you know, sometimes you have to take the rough with the smooth, sometimes there's been delays, but most importantly for us is that we don't deliver a product that is not what we said we were going to deliver.
Are you doing anything new for NAB this year?
I'm sure there may be some things that may be of interest.
Nobody will know. I won't tell a soul. You can just whisper in my ear what you're going to do.
I think that what's going to be great with NAB this year is that people who have followed Blackmagic along the last few years have known that Blackmagic at NAB has got bigger and bigger and bigger, and some of our announcements have been crazy announcements. I think for us, every time that we go up to April and we look at NAB, we get a bit of a fear factor. It sends a tingle down your spine. It makes you think to yourself, you know, is everyone going to love everything that we do? I'd love to tell you what's going to happen. I'd love to tell you what's going to be new. I'm going to let you wait until April.
For people that want more information about the wide range of products that Blackmagic has available, where can they go on the web?
Well, all of our information about the products can be found at www.blackmagicdesign.com. At that website, you'll see all of the information about each of the products individually, but also we've got a forum on there as well where you can share and communicate with other people. And if anybody ever wants to speak with any of our team, you know, we're always at trade shows, we always can be contactable via phone or email. We're always willing to listen to the comments and the thoughts that people have so that we can improve and make our products better.